Something is about to be ended today. Amen. If your open is now that God will end this story. Amen. I said God will end this story. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Go ahead, ma'am.
And in this place.
Verse 5. Okay.
And in this place again.
And in this place again.
If they shall enter into my rest.
If they shall enter into my rest.
See therefore. It remaineth that song. Must enter therein.
Can I get your attention?
Yes, sir.
Let me say. And in this place again, if they shall enter into my rest. See therefore, it remains that some must enter. In other words, that rest never finished. It still remains. Oh, come on here. I said, the rest never finished. It still remains. I said, it still remains.
Yes,
somebody say, my portion is there. I receive my portion. Can I tell you something? One of the confidence I have in preaching this is because I know that the rest has not finished. Is anybody here? I said, why I am preaching confidently is because I know that rest has not finished. It's still there.
Amen.
Hear me. If it's still there, then your own will enter your heart.
Amen.
I said, if the rest still remain, then your own will reach your hand.
Amen.
But I know that somebody are hearing me right now. You have more them than your own will enter your hand.
Amen.
As they enter their hand in the time passed, your own is now.
Amen.
I say, your own is now.
Amen.
God shall give you rest. I said, the Lord shall give you rest.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't say it's still remain. Somebody say it's still remain.
It's still remain.
I hear he said. Go ahead, man.
And then to him to whom it was first preached.
Yes, go ahead.
Entered not into because of unbelief.
Them that received the message before did not enter because of their unbelief. Then seven.
Again. He limited. A certain day.
Saying in David.
Today. After so long a time.
As it is said.
Today. If you hear his voice.
Harden not your heart. If you will hear this prophecy, don't harden your heart. Don't disbelieve. Open your heart for the word to come.
Amen.
Because the word that is coming will be fulfilled.
Amen.
Go ahead, man.
For if Jesus had given them rest.
Now stop here. Now the word Jesus here is not talking about our Christ, our Messiah. This Jesus here means Joshua. So another name for Jesus is Joshua. And that is where we get Yeshua. Praise the Lord. Joshua, maybe we call it in English, but in Hebrew it's Yeshua. Yeshua HaMashiach. That's Jesus. So when you see this Jesus here, it's a typology of Joshua. Now hear me clearly. Let me clear this to you. When he said, if Jesus had given them rest, so not Jesus that we say in the name of Jesus, not Jesus our master, no. Then the Jesus is talking about here, hear me clearly, is that Joshua. Because Joshua is a typology of Jesus. Hear me clearly, follow me carefully. It takes Jesus to take you to your rest. Nobody can lead him to rest. That was why when they were led from Egypt to the promised land, they get to a place where they're supposed to enter into their rest, the land that filled with milk and honey. But Moses does not characterize Jesus. So Moses was not qualified to take them into the promised land. But they had to bring Joshua. So that Joshua is the typology of Jesus. So Moses had to stop for Jesus to take you in. It has to be Jesus to lead you into rest. Is everybody wrong saying here? So if it is not Jesus, we cannot have rest. Jesus is the one that can give you rest, and then nothing questions your rest. So he now said, if Joshua had given them rest, then go ahead, man.
Would he not afterward have spoken of another day?
In other words, if this Joshua had given them rest, why would they be asking of another rest? That means therefore the rest that Joshua gave them was not actually the main rest. The rest that he gave them was not actually what they are looking for. If that was rest, why are they asking of another rest? Praise the Lord. In the Old Testament, they entered into the land that was filled with milk and honey, and they thought that it was over. No, that was not what Jesus wants for you. That was not what God wants for you. But the milk will finish, honey will finish, everything that you need, you eat will finish. But there is one that is coming. It's coming from the Son of the Living God. If it comes from His hand, it will enter your hand, and it shall not finish. Because anything that Jesus gives you, it lasts forever. Whatever thing that comes from Jesus has no barrier. It lasts forever. I don't care to know where you stop. I don't care to know what you have had in time past. There is a fresh wine that is coming. That when you take of that wine, you shall ask, where did this wine come from? And that is the Holy Spirit. That is a gift from Jesus in someone's life. There is a gift that is coming. There is a rest that is coming. Not the type of a rest that you have, you ask for another. But it's the type of a rest that you have, you will not ask for another. Because it's the best rest that carries everything you are looking for. In that rest, your long life is there. In that rest, your success is there. Your prosperity is here. Your holiness is here. Your deliverance is here. Your family blessing is here. Whatever thing you are looking for, you ask the people to help you. It's in that rest. I don't know why I am saying this. There's something telling me in my spirit. There's somebody. God is giving you rest. From this ministration, rest is coming. I say, rest is coming. In the name of Jesus Christ. Rest is coming.
Amen.
Rest is coming.
Amen.
Jesus said, for you that is troubled, rest. Amen. It takes him to give you rest.
Amen.
So when you see Joshua was the kind of Jesus. Because he begged Jesus to take them to rest. So now Joshua was one who took them into rest. And that was in the Old Testament. And here in the New Testament, a question arose and said, if that was the rest, oh come on, would they have been asking for another rest? That is, they entered into that rest and we are still looking for another rest. In other words, that was not the original rest. That was the rest that Joseph took them into. But there's another rest that is coming that Jesus is taking you to.
Yeah.
And he said, there's another rest that is coming that Jesus is taking you to.
Yeah.
Except the Lord build the house, they that labor in vain. Except the Lord watch the city, they that watch in vain. It has to be except the Lord. If it is not God who did it, it will not be perfect. And when it is done, the hand of God, then you have every reason to stand with the boldness hitting hand on your chest and say, this is a lost winner, and it is marvelous in our sight.
Yeah.
And I hear you said, forgive me from someone.
Yeah.
And I hear what he said, what's that? For if Jesus, if Joshua had given them rest, then would he not afterward have spoken of another day? Then he now said, verse 9, there remained therefore a rest to the people of God. There remained therefore rest to who? To the people of God. Keeping up a Sabbath. Okay, now that goes on. But now, see here, I want to show you. Go down to 11. Go back to 11. He said, let us therefore labor to enter into that rest, lest any more fall into the same example. He said, therefore, there remained a rest. That rest still remained. It still remained. It's not the one that they were given. There's another one. This one is different from the one they were given. This one came from Jesus himself. This is a rest that was given to you by redemption. This is the rest that was given to you on the cross. And when he said it is finished, when he said it is finished, it is finished. When he said it is finished, it is finished. This is the rest that was proclaimed on the cross. He said it is finished. This is the rest that was proclaimed on the cross. He said that today I shall rest with you in the paradise. This is that proclamation that came from Jesus on the cross. This rest is offered to you. This rest is made available to you by redemption. It is the gift of redemption. It is the product of redemption. So when you are born again, you have access to this rest. If any man is in Christ Jesus, all things are passed away. Behold, every other thing becomes new. Something is coming new in your life because Jesus is taking preeminence. If your amen is louder, your life changes from this moment. As your life changes from this moment, in the name of Jesus. Now hear what he said. He said, therefore, there remained another rest for the people of God. That is what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. There remained a rest for the people. He said, let us labor, therefore. Let us work hard. Let us believe. Let us do all that it takes. Let us be born again. Let us fast. Let us pray. Let us serve God. Let us stay away from sin. Let us stay away from iniquity. Because it is not easy to live another life. It's not easy to live God's life. When you are doing, when you are used to your own life, worldly life, it is not easy to live a godly life. And when you are trying to live godly life, it's a struggle. Because you are trying to live that kind of other life, but you want to go and something don't go. You are struggling to live godly life. It's a labor. It's a little labor. Therefore, see that we enter into that rest. Because in that place you cease it from your own labor. In that place you cease it from your own labor. In that place you cease it from your own labor. No one labors in that place. And I can tell you something. That place is called the Zion. That place is called the Zion. Now let me show you where it is. Let me show you where that place is. Hallelujah. Psalm 78. Psalm 87 verse 4. Psalm 87 verse 4. And you're going to read it for me. Thank you, Jesus. That is a dress I'm bringing to you now. Somebody, God is giving you rest. Hear me. The last time we had that evil dream, the last time we have it. I didn't hear amen. I said, the last time that evil before your family, it shall be the last time. The last time every member of your family gather together and weep and mourn and cry, will be the last time you will never cry. The last time that you say that you don't have, the last time that a negative words come out from your mouth, as a result of what you are going through, shall be the last time you shall speak negative words in the name of Jesus Christ. Now look at what he said. Read it on. Read on. Verse 4.
I will make mention of Rahab
and Babylon.
To them that know me.
Behold.
Philistia. And Tyre. With Ethiopia. This man was born there. And of Zion it shall be said. This and that man.
Was born in her. Now stop there. And Zion it shall be said. That this man was born in Zion. Now hear what that 4:5 said. What that 4 said. He said, I will make mention of Rahab and Babylon to them that know me. Behold, the Philistine and the Tyre with Ethiopian. He said, if I can make mention of this one, then I will not choose among them that I mentioned and know the particular person that was born there. Now watch this. He mentioned Rahab and Babylon 2, and the Philistine 3, Tyre 4, and Ethiopia 5. He should have said that this man we are born there. But he didn't say this man, he said this man. Because among the 5, I'm going to choose someone that is born in Zion. That is born in Zion. When you are translated into that rest, you actually be born into that rest.
Yeah.
I say you actually be born into that rest.
Yeah.
And I hear what he said. When the Lord, where is the 5? He said, and of Zion it shall be said, this man, that woman was born in Zion. Because when you enter into that rest, you become a citizen of that rest. Did anybody hear what I said? When you enter into that rest, everything about you changes. Can I tell you something? When you become a citizen of a particular country, you begin to behave like them. You see, all these boys, children that you born here in Spain, when they grow up and they talk like Spanish people, they behave like Spanish people. If you present the same child of 13 years old and the 13 years old that is born in Nigeria, their character is different. They are the same age, but the environment affects them. It takes environment. Anywhere you dwell, that is how you behave. But in Zion, when you are born in Zion, when you live in the rest, it affects your life. It affects the way you talk, the way you look things. You don't see things the way other people see things. You don't talk the way others talk. Can I tell you something? When you enter in Zion, first and foremost place, that in Zion, the rest that affects your life is in your mouth. Is in here? In your mouth. Remember before you used to say, you don't afoka, you don't spoil, I don't die. That was your former language. But when you enter into rest, your mouth changes. Your mouth changes. You no longer speak, you don't spoil. You no longer speak, I don't die. You no longer speak all those words. But what you speak is what you experience. What you speak is what happens around you. Because in Zion, there is no struggle. In Zion, your struggle ceases. In Zion, your deliverance. Remember, upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. As long as you enter there, your deliverance begins. And the manifestation of your deliverance begins. speaking from your mouth. You will accuse somebody that from today, your mouth shall not speak evil. Your mouth shall not blaspheme. Your mouth shall not speak evil. Your mouth shall not blaspheme. In the name of Jesus. Because the thing that happens in Zion shall begin to affect your mouth. Hallelujah. It shall begin to affect your mouth. I don't know why I am talking like this, but I don't know, but something tells me that somebody, God is translating you into your rest. Amen. When he said there you let the rest, where is that rest? That rest is Zion. So what that rest is where?
Zion.
In Zion, two places happen. Number one, deliverance. Upon Mount Zion, there shall be what? Deliverance. Then second thing is your mouth, your language changes. Just it's a question of time. Step 10 years ahead. Just a question of time when we are given the authority to become a citizen of this country, even your tongue will be affected. Check the way you talk to your people. Sometimes when you are talking to your brother, your sister, you say, no, no. You try to, he doesn't know what you are saying, but you understand. Praise the Lord. You put small Spanish in when you are talking to your mother when in Nigeria. Because the environment has affected you. And when it affects you, it is expressed in your mouth. With our heart, we believe unto righteousness. With our mouth, the confession is made unto salvation. But from today, may you speak testimonies. I say, but from today, may you speak testimonies. May what happens around you be a testimony in your mouth. Because good things shall begin to happen in such a way that you will not see evil found in your mouth. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' precious name. Can I hear amen from somebody? Hallelujah. Now look at Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 10. Thank you, Jesus. Karabusha. Hebrews Karabusha. Are we there? Hebrews chapter 11 verse 10. Hey, read on.
For he looked for a city.
For he is looking for a city.
Which have foundation.
Which have foundation.
Whose builder and maker?
Is God. Now watch this. This rest we are talking about, remember, I said that rest is Zion. And Zion is a city. And he said that city still remains, there's still opportunity. And here is a man whom God told, you got to leave your father's house. You have to leave your brethren, leave your kinsmen to that city that I will show you. And then he embarked on the journey looking for a city. Because the city is not in Agege. The city is not in Overhill. The city is not in Onitsha. The city is not the city that is made by man. The city is a city that was made by God. And somebody tracking on his way and say, what are you looking for? You look frustrated, you look like you're searching for something. And he said, I am looking for a city. In that city, let me describe the city to you in case if you have seen the city before. And the man said, what kind of city are you looking for? He said, I am looking for a city where the maker of that city, the builder of that city is God himself. And where people shall gather, and the God shall not be ashamed to be called the people of God. Where they shall not be ashamed to say that this is my God. I am talking about a city that has been prepared for you. That city is not made by men. It's not made by female, is not made by human, but that city was made by God. Can I tell you something? In that city, if you will enter, our brother will not enter. If you live in that city, no HIV. If you live in that city, no witch, no wizard. Can I tell you something? That city is a city that has a spiritual structure. Can I tell you how you look like? The city is looking like a program. So when he said that, the righteous. The rector said, run into it. He said, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. That is the description of the city. It's a strong tower. And they that are righteous in God, when they run into that tower, they are safe. Because when they enter into that city, you are safe from attack. You are safe from armorers. You are safe from kidnappers. You are safe from witches and wizards. You are safe from struggling. You are safe from what happened to people out there. Because your life shall be different. I can say to somebody, congratulations, when you come to that city, I say, welcome to that city. I say, welcome to that city. Welcome to that city. The city that the maker and the builder is God himself. It's a city we are going to. It's a city you have just entered. Hear me, I say it prophetically. You shall carry this tender into the next water. Next one is the boat of your rest. I said, this one is the boat of your rest. Somebody, you are carrying the symbol already. You are carrying the symbol already. It's a symbol of rest. It's a symbol of rest. It's a symbol of rest. I said, welcome to that city. Welcome to that city. Welcome to that country. Welcome to that country. The country of God. The city of Jehovah. The city of Solemnities. We are no one saying that I will struggle anymore. We are life shall be made easy. We are life shall be made easy. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hear me. Before I pray for you, I want to read two scriptures. Then I pray for you. Then tell the world to get ready for her. For her birthday. Thank you, Jesus. Now hear this. Labro Katusha, brothers. He said he was looking for the city. Why was he looking for it? Because it was not sitting made by man. Hear this. Did you know that people were not seeing that city? The same place where he walked, he was looking for a city. And somebody walked to him and said, what are you looking for? Were an angel or a human being? He said, I am looking for a city. He said, what city are you talking about? He said, the city may not have a specific name, but the architect, the engineer, the man who made it is the man who built the city. The man who built the city is the man that built the city. You know the promise? He said, dear Lebanon, and the harvest is a promise. He said, the man that promised that city is the man that built the city. They are looking for a city that is a fulfillment of a promise. A fulfillment of a promise. The maker and the builder, the architect of that city is God. And he built it for his people. He said, where my people shall not be ashamed to call me their God. Where somebody will not be going to church and put Bible in the pocket. Where somebody will not be a born again Israel, goes against Tomalaka and become a masculinity. Where somebody cannot deny Jesus. Where somebody cannot compromise his faith. Where somebody will say, I will serve God. We come and come. Where somebody will say, God, remove me, build me, until ego get out of my life, until foolishness disappears from me, until I begin to reason, until I give my life fully to you. If somebody, God is saying that, until you come to that level, where I am not going to be ashamed for you to present to people, I'm your God. Do you know some of you, if somebody asks you, do you go to church? You say, no, I don't go to church. Just because you want to do some foolish kind of thing with a person. And the way I'm seeing you now, and the way you go to church now, is that you're going to be a pastor in the future. That is a girl asking you, are you going to be a pastor in the future? You just deny it to the face. No, I'm not going to be a pastor just because you want the girl to accept you. Anyone who cannot accept you because you're a child of God does not deserve you. Anyone who cannot support you to serve God does not deserve you. Anyone who cannot help you and push you to God does not deserve you. A place where God will not be ashamed for people to say, I am their God. Because it shall come to pass on the last day. If you are ashamed of me here on this earth, I shall be ashamed of you before my Father in heaven. Where God shall not be ashamed to call his God. Where they not be ashamed to call God their God. May God affect your lives. The light shines. The light shines upon your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, my Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Isaiah chapter 33. Isaiah chapter 33, verse 24. Isaiah chapter 33, verse 24. Somebody say, I am there. Are you there? Isaiah 3:24. Then hear me. 3:24.
And the inhabitants shall not say,
and that that inhabits that place, them that enter into that rest, them that enter into the city, shall not say what? Go on.
I am sick.
Them that live in that city shall not say, I am sick. Stop there. Do you see that? The people that live in Zion, the people that God has given rest, shall not say, I am sick. You know why? Because your mouth will be affected. You shall not say, I am sick. I am poor. Can I tell you your sickness? The sickness there is a typology of disease. And disease was gotten from the translation, dis-ease. So anything that makes you dis-ease, when you say ease, is freedom. Dis-ease anything that diseases you is a sickness. Whatever thing that does not give you comfort. So disease could be poverty, could be sickness, could be disease, could be whatever. Hear me. Anything that diseases you in life is sickness. He said, they that dwell there, God shall truly punish them. God shall truly deliver them. God shall truly clean them up. They shall not find any iota of negative words in their mouth. He said, none of them that live there shall say, I am sick. None of them from there, none of them that live there shall say, I am sick. None of them that live there shall say, I am poor. None of them from there shall say, there is a demon troubling my life. None of them from there shall speak some ill words. Because the devil, we have no access. With the devil, we have nothing to do with someone who is a citizen of a resting place. May God translate you to that place. Where your language shall change. Where you shall no longer say, I am sick. Can I tell you something? Anything you say determines what happens around you. If you say you are sick, that means your body is sick. Then if you don't say you are sick, that means you are not sick. Then if God says you shall not say you are sick, that means you will heal you. We will take away sickness. We take away disease from you. You shall bless your cup. You shall bless your water, bless your bread. And you shall take away disease that you don't know anything about. That fall on your fathers in Egypt. He said you shall take them away from you. Every disease in your life will be washed and poured away from your life because you dwell in the city. The things that happen there are testimonies. The things that happen there are testimonies. Where you shall testify how good the Lord is. Where you shall testify, come and join me. Paul will say that which I have eaten and given to death is a good one. Eat it as well. I have tested it, it is good. I tested it, it was wonderful. Eat what I give to you because I am eating it also. Where you shall say to somebody, I confidently say, come to Jesus. Come to my church. Come to my God. Come to the place where I dwell. Come to my dwelling place. Can I tell you something? When you live in the city, it doesn't matter your location. I might be living in the same house with you, but I live from the city that the maker and doer is God. That's why I am not sick, but you are sick all the time. That's why I am not failing, you are failing all the time. Even though we are born of the same parents, we live in the same place. It doesn't matter. Something may be befalling you, it does not befall me. We may come from one room, but we belong from different places. I am talking to somebody whom God is taking on a journey from today. Into a particular rest, into a city where you shall not say I am sick, where you shall not say I am poor, because your blood will shall change from today. In the name of Jesus. Now hear this. Hear the last verse. About the city. Isaiah chapter 65 from verse 19. Thank you, Jesus. And this is you now. Isaiah 65 from verse 19. Down to 24. Let me hear you. Thank you, Jesus. Now look up there.
And it says. And I will rejoice in Jerusalem.
I will rejoice in Jerusalem.
And joy in my people. And the voice of weeping shall be no more.
Come and somebody say amen.
Amen.
You don't enjoy the story. You receive the blessing. Don't enjoy the story. Pastor, I like the way you preach. No, don't enjoy how I preach. But receive the voice of God for what I'm saying.
Amen.
So when we come to this place, what do you say? You receive with an amen. Can you read it again? Now let me see those who are prophetic and who understand what I'm saying.
And I will rejoice
in Jerusalem.
And joy in my people. And the voice of weeping shall be no more.
And the voice of crying and sorrow shall be no more.
Amen.
Shall be no more. You know why? Because you are now in the city.
Yes.
Now, let's go on. Go on.
Verse 20. There shall be no more deaths.
An infant of death, meaning there shall be no more untimely deaths.
Amen.
He said, there shall be no more death than this wicked die untimely.
Amen.
Can I tell you something?
Yes, sir.
Oh, my goodness. Listen to me. As you receive this grace, may you not die early. Can I tell you when life really begins in the eyes of God? The life of a man of God, the life of a child of God begins from the 100. All these 80 years, you say, don't try, now suffer. Life begins from 100 years up. Now 100, that God knows that I don't grow.
Yes.
But for we, 100, they laugh, they rejoice, they die for fear, they die well. But in the eyes of God, in the city we are talking about, 100 years is the beginning of your life.
Amen.
And you know, it was Abraham who was looking for the city. He actually got the city. And it was on 100 years he gave birth to him, to a covenant child. 100 years, that was when he started to bring them into life. 100 years, he said, there shall be no more death of infants. Not even 70 years, not even 80 years. Do you know that there are some 70, 80 years of your grandparents that still talk? Why do you cry when your grandparents, when your grandparents die? Why do you cry? Because you love and you are going to miss her. If the woman is still there, you will still be happy. So no more dying early when you get to that city.
Amen.
Somebody will not miss your way to that city.
Amen.
Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
Verse 21. And they shall build houses.
And they shall live in the house.